Hello students, how are you all? I hope you all are fine and healthy. So today again we are here for learning science. In science we learn about different type of things, different type of food, different type of animals and many other things. We learn about importance of house, we learn about different safety rules and we learn about the air and water. We learn about living thing and we also learn about what living things need to live. We learn that living things need air, water and food to live, right? So all these things we learn in science. Then in lesson number 13 we learn about weather, different type of weather, hot days, cold days, windy days and rainy days. So all these things we learn in science. In science we learn different every day. So let's start our today's lecture. As you know, I am your science teacher Mubassira Miss from Mahdi School. And today we continue our lesson number 14. The name of this lesson is The Sun, Moon and Star. Our today's topic is fair book exercise. So we already revised sun and moon and today we write fill in the blanks in fair book. So let's start our today's lecture. In this lesson we learn about the sun, moon and star, right? So first we quickly revise the sun, moon and star and then we revise hard words and then we write fill in the blanks. So let's start our today's lecture with one beautiful line. So here you can see on your screen the picture also and you can see the line also. That when you feel like giving up, look back at how far you come. Be strong, stay on your path, never stop going. So here you can see that one boy is on the stairs. So when you face problems, right, at that time, just look back that where you are. You are climbing stairs from 1 to 5 and you can see how you are growing. And you can see your path also, right? So keep yourself going on. Don't stop anywhere because you are already near to succeed, right? So when you feel like giving up, look back at how far you are come. Be strong, stay on your path, never stop going, right? So with this beautiful line, let's start our today's lecture. So in this lesson, we learn about sun. So first we quickly revise that what we learn in this lesson, right? So first when we learn about sun, we learn that sun is a big ball of fire. The color of sun is yellow, right? We learn that sun is a big ball of fire. That's why the sun is giving us heat and light. We all know that sun is very important thing, right? Why? Because without sun, there is no water cycle, there is no plant growing, there is no water, there is no food. And sun is giving us heat and light, right? So at night, when there is no sun in the sky, you can see the dark sky. Right? So in morning we all know because of sunlight there is light. So sun is a big ball of fire. The color of the sun is yellow or orange. In this lesson we learn about sun and we also learn about sunrise and sunset. So what is the meaning of sunrise and sunset? We learn that in morning when sunrise it brings us day. Right? And when you see sunset, it means it bring us night. So sun is giving us heat, light and sun bring us day. how in east the sun rise, in west the sun set. When sun set in evening, it bring us night. So if there is no sun, then the stay night, right? The day will not start. So sun is an important thing. Sun give us heat and light. All living things can't live without sun, because sun give us heat and light. In everything we need heat. If you want to grow plant, you need heat. You all know that plants need three things to grow. Which are they? Air, water and sunlight. And if there is no heat in our life, like we are in place where is snow, so at that time if there is no sun, right, so the snow will not melt, right? So you can understand what is the importance of the sun, right? So here you can see the picture of sun, and sun is a big yellow ball of fire, right? Then second picture you can see on your screen, the picture of star. So in this lesson we also learn about star, that stars are very tiny. It is too far away from us, that's why we can see very small stars. But when you see star in real, the thing is that stars are very big. They are bigger than sun also, right? So you can understand the sun is a big star. When the stars are also big star, but why they are looking tiny? Because the stars are far away from us, right? So in this lesson we learn about star. Stars are in different color, yellow, sometime it is red, sometime it is silver, sometime it is in red color, blue color. And we learn about star that stars are making pattern in the sky, right? We also learn about shooting stars. So it is the fallen star, and there is one thing, people think that if you wish anything when you see the shooting star, but when you want to see shooting star, it is compulsory that you need to see sky very carefully and with concentrate, so you can find the shooting star, right? So it is the thing which we learn about stars. Stars are making pattern in the sky. You can see that great bear and many other patterns in the sky, right? Then we learn about moon, right? So what we learn about moon, we already revised moon in previous lecture also. So what we learn about moon, that moon is looking like a big yellow ball or white ball. Give answer. Moon is a big yellow ball or moon is a big white ball? White ball, right? Because yellow ball is a sun. So the sun is a big yellow ball and the moon is a big white ball, right? So here you can see sun, moon and star. In this lesson we learn about sun, moon and star. So what we learn about moon? That moon is a big yellow ball? No. Moon is a big white ball, right? So the color of moon is white. So don't confused between the moon and sun, right? So what we learn about moon, that moon changes every night. The shape of the moon is changes every night. So when you observe the sky every day from 1 to 13 day, the moon increase, then after 15 days the moon decrease, right? So in one day, in one month, the full moon you can see in the sky, and one day there is no moon in the sky. The day after new moon is the first day of the moon phase. So this shape and size of the moon changes every night, right? So what we called it? We called it phases of the moon, right? So when we learn about moon, we learn that sometime you see moon in the sky during the day also. So when we learn about moon and star, we also learn that moon and star we can see in the sky at night. We cannot see them during the day. Why? Because of the sunlight. Because the sunlight is very bright, and because of that, the moonlight and the light of the stars are we cannot see, right? So that's why we cannot see moon and stars in day, right? So we learn about moon, we learn about phases of the moon, we learn about stars. Stars are looking very tiny and they make pattern in the sky. Then we learn about sunrise and sunset. So sunrise bring us day, when sunset bring us night. In morning from east sunrise, in evening from west you can disappear the sun and you can see this. So sun is the important thing, because sun bring us day also and sun bring us night also. It give us heat and light also, right? So here you can see day and night, from east to west sun is there, right? So we also learn that sun is not going anywhere. The earth where we all are living is moving and roaming. That's why we are moving and roaming around the sun, right? So the sun is on the place, but we are moving and roaming, right? So this all things we learn in this lesson. Lesson number 14, the sun, moon and star, right? So all these things we learn in science in this lesson. So let's revise what we learn in hard words, right? So we quickly revise hard word and then we write the fill in the blanks. So let's see what we learn in hard words quickly. The hard word number 1, sun, right? So here you can see the spelling of sun. What is the spelling of sun? S-U-N, sun, and you can see the picture of sun also. So sun is a big yellow ball of fire, right? So you can understand that what is the sun and why we called it yellow ball of fire. As you know that sometimes sun is color in orange, sometimes it is looking like orange also, but the sun is a big yellow ball of fire. Then our second hard word, F-I-R-E. You already learn about fire in lesson number 13, in lesson number 10 also, that we should stay away from fire. We learn about fire in lesson number 10, right? And when we learn about winter in lesson number 13, we learn that fire give us heat. We are don't go near to fire, but it give us heat in winter. So here you can see the picture of fire in this lesson. What we learn about fire? That the sun is a big ball of fire, right? So what is the spelling of fire? F-I-R-E, fire. Then our third hard word is H-E-A-T. So what is meaning of heat? Because we learn about sun in this lesson and we all know that sun is giving us heat, right? So here you can see the heat of the sun and you can see one girl. And what is the girl is doing? Girl having ice cream, the candy. And because of sunlight, because of the heat of the sunlight, the candy melt, right? So that's why here you can see the heat. So it means sun give us heat. And what is the spelling of heat? H-E-A-T, right? Then our next hard word, L-I-G-H-T. So in this lesson, as you learn that sun give us light, and you can see in this picture slowly, slowly, because of sun there is light. So we also learn about sunlight, because the light which we get from sun, we called it sunlight, right? So here you can see the picture of light. In this lesson we learn about light, it is sunlight. Then our next hard word is sunrise. So here you can see the sunrise, and as you all know, okay, we learn in this lesson that sunrise bring us day, right? So here you can see the picture of sunrise, and you can see here good morning also. So when the sun rise, it means the morning start. That's why in morning we all are wishing each other good morning, right? So it is the picture of sunrise. And what is the spelling of sunrise? SUNRISE. Then our next word is sunset. So like sunrise, the sunset also. So here you can see the picture of sunset, and sunset bring us night. So sunrise also important, and the sunset is also important, because whole day because of sun there is light and there is heat. When the sun set at that time, it bring us night, and it is giving us moon also and stars also, because sun is not in the sky at that time, we can see moon and stars, right? So sunset bring us night. SUNSET. Then our next hard word is bring, BRING. So in this lesson we learn about bring, that sun bring us day, sunset bring us night. So that's why here you can see sunset and sunrise also. BRING, bring. EAST, it is the direction from sunrise. So here you can see the sunrise, and you can see the sun is rise from the east. It is the direction, EAST. Then our next hard word is west. So where sunset, in which direction? It is the west, WEST. From this side, from east, sunrise and sunset into the west, right? So here you can see the picture of sunrise or sunset. It is sunset. So where sunset, sunset in west, right? Then the next thing, moon, 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 right? So we already learn about moon. Here you can see the picture of moon, a big white ball. Don't confuse between sun and moon. Sun is a yellow ball of fire, when the moon is a white ball, right? Then our next hard word is night, NIGHT. So here you can see the little star, right? So what is this? It is night, NIGHT. Observe, it means observe carefully, see anything very carefully, right? So that's why here you can see the children are observe the sky carefully. Shape. So in this lesson we learn about shape of the moon, which known as a phases of the moon, right? So SHAPE, which is changes every night. Phases of the moon, here you can see the picture of phases of the moon. The shape of the moon changes every night, and these shape are known as the phases of the moon, right? Stars, here you can see the stars. You all are stars, you are little stars of first standard, right? So like that, STARS, stars. Then our next hard word is tiny. So here you can see the picture of moon and stars, right? And the stars are very tiny. So I circle the stars, right? So they are looking tiny when the moon is a big, right? So TINY, tiny. Far away, it means here you can see the picture of one house and stars are far away, right? So that's why FARAWAY. Patterns, in this lesson we learn about patterns, but which patterns? The patterns which we can see in the sky, which is formed by the stars. So here you can see the picture of patterns which formed by the stars, right? Great Bear, it is the one of the pattern which made by stars, right? Then our today's topic is fill in the blanks. So what we have to do in this, we have one sentence, so we have to fill this blank. We have two options, one option is right, one is wrong, so we have to choose the correct answer. So let's see our first FB. Number one, the sun rises in the dash. So in this lesson we learn about sunrise and sunset. We also learn about sun, that sun is a big yellow ball of fire, and we also learn that sunrise bring us day, sun give us light. So when you see sun in the sky, it means it is day, right? So here we have two options, east and west, right? So these two are directions, right? We all learn about this, east to west. We know that sunset and sunrise in west or east, right? So we have to choose that from which direction the sun rise, right? So let's see here the picture. It is the picture of sunrise, and here you can see the direction also. In which direction it is? It is east, east, right? So what is the answer here? The answer is west, or answer is east, because when we learn about sunrise and sunset, we also learn about the directions, right? So from one side the sun rise, and in the other side, the opposite side, the sun set. So from which side the sun rise, is that east or west? So here you can see the picture of east, right? So what is the answer? The answer is east, east, right? So sun sets into the west, and the east and west, they are opposite from each other. The direction is opposite from each other, right? So you can understand that east, west, north and south, right? So these four directions we have, right? So from this, from east the sun rise, and in the west the sun set, and when the sun set, it bring us night. So I write the answer here, east. The sun rises in the east. The west is the wrong answer. Why? Because the sun set into the west, right? Then our next FB, we see the stars at the day or night. We have to give answer, day or night, right? So here you can see two options, day and night. Now let's see what we have here. Here you can see the picture of stars, and stars are very tiny, right? They are brighter but sprinkles, right? So they known as tiny stars, right? So we also learn the poem Twinkle Twinkle Little Stars like that. So when we see the star, right? So when you see sun in the sky, at that time you see the stars? No, it is day, right? Because the sunrise bring us day, right? So it means in the day, during the day, you cannot see the stars. But when the sun set, at that time it bring us night, right? So at that time you can see the star, right? So we see the stars at night or day? It is night. Here you can see, because the color of the star is a white, and during the day this white color you cannot see, right? Remember that stars are in the sky during the day also, but we can see them at night because during the day there is sunlight, right? So what is the answer? Night. We see the stars at the night. So what is the answer? Night. And here you can see the picture of night also, and you can see the picture of stars also. Now let's see our next fill in the blank. The next blank is, the moon is a big dash ball, right? So what we have to do in this, we have to write the color of the moon, right? So when we learn about sun, we learn that sun is a big yellow ball of fire. When we learn about stars, we learn that sometimes stars are yellow, sometimes it is silver, sometimes it is red, blue, right? So when we learn about moon, it is looking like a big ball, right? But which color? Here you can see the picture of moon. And what is the color of moon? Is that yellow? Is that green? Is that blue? Which color it is? White, right? So what is the answer? The answer is white. W-H-I-T-E. Sometimes the moon is looking like a pink, light pink color. It means baby pink color. Sometimes, but mostly you can see moon in which shape it is. Whatever the shape of the moon, is that a crescent, is it a half moon, right? So at that time the moon's color is white. So that's why the answer is W-H-I-T-E, white. The color of moon is white, not a blue color, right? So the moon is a big white ball, right? So I write here the answer W-H-I-T-E. Then our next FB, stars are looking dash. We have two options here, tiny and big. So when we learn about stars, when we learn about sun, and when we learn about moon, so which thing are small? Sun, moon or star? Which thing is small? We all know that sun is a big. Moon is a big, but not bigger than sun or not as a sun. When we see the stars, stars are very small. So tiny means, it means the small thing, right? So here you can see the picture of moon and star. So which thing is small? Because we have to write here big or small, right? So tiny means small. So here you can see the moon. And the stars, you can see, I circle the stars, right? So it is big or small? It is small. So stars are looking big or tiny? So the moon is big when the stars are tiny. So what is the answer? The answer is T-I-N-Y, tiny. Stars are looking tiny when the moon is a big and sun is bigger than the moon, right? So they are big. They are big star than the sun also. But the thing is that the stars are far away from us. That's why the stars looking tiny. In real, the stars are very, very, very big, right? So they are far away from us. That's why it look like a tiny. Then our next fill in the blank is dash give us light and heat. We have two options here, sun and moon. The sun and moon, both things give us light. Here you can see the picture of moon. Moon give us white color light when the sun give us yellow color light. Now, which thing give us heat? Sun give us heat or moon give us heat? We have to identify, right? Because the sun and the moon both give us light. As we know, in night the moon give us light, in day during the day sun give us light. And which thing give us heat? It is sun. Right now the summer season running, right? So we feel heat. Why? Because of the sun, right? So what give us light and heat? It is sun. When the moon give us light only, moon is not giving us heat, only sun give us heat. So here I write the answer S-U-N, sun give us light and heat. Again I repeat that sun and moon both are giving light, but the heat which we get during the day, and sometimes we feel the heat of the sun in night also, right? So which thing give us heat and light? Both. Stars give us light or heat? No. Star is very tiny. That's why the light of the stars are far away from us, right? So only two things give us light, sun and moon. And from this, the sun is only thing which give us light and heat both. Right, so I write here the answer. Sun gives light and heat. Right, so here we complete our fill in the blanks. Right, so what we done today? We complete hard words. First we revise hard words, then we revise this lesson about sun, moon and star, then we write the fill in the blanks. So I hope you all understand what we learned today. I hope you all enjoy this lecture. So take care of yourself and stay healthy.